So Elon Musk is not having a good day in the Johnny Depp versus the Sun libel trial. Why? Because his name has come up amongst other things, and people are saying, well, maybe he's responsible for all of those things that happened to AA. So hey there. Now before we get started, this is our second comic book. Link is in the description, and we have 30 plus hours remaining. We need your help getting the word out there too, because we talk about this stuff, we talk about due process, and well, that makes us the bad guys, but that's okay. We don't need the people that are out there calling us that. We need you. So check out the comic, back it, share it, and thank you, as always. Now, when I'm covering this stuff today, I want to make one thing perfectly clear. I'm not accusing anyone of anything. In fact, the reason that I cover this stuff is because people are getting canceled all the time. I do not like that. I believe in due process. I do find some humor in this, though, because Elon Musk has been pointing the finger at Johnny Depp, doing it openly, and I'm sure that he doesn't like the finger pointed back at him. Really sucks, doesn't it? So this is an article from the Daily Mail. Elon Musk, and not Johnny Depp, could have given AH cuts and bruises during affair as her marriage to the actor crumbled. Penthouse concierge bombshell claim. Now, these claims, they come together from not one, but two building staff members who worked at the apartment block where AH and Johnny Depp lived in a penthouse on the 13th floor. Now, in sworn video statements, Alejandro Romero, I'm hoping I pronounced these right, and Trinity Esperanza say that they saw no injuries to AH's face after Depp allegedly threw a mobile phone at her, quote-unquote, like a baseball pitcher during a blazing row on May 21st. Mr. Esperanza, who owned a concierge company at the exclusive Eastern Columbia building, says she saw AH throughout the week after the alleged phone-hurling assault, and the actress, who wore no makeup, showed neither bruises nor cuts. Then on Friday, May 27th, she, quote, had a red cut underneath her right eye and red marks by her eye. Now, interestingly enough, that timeline, it is a fascinating thing. Why? Because this is a picture talking about May 27th. You can see the outline on the face, but the only problem leading up to that is there is CCTV footage available. It's for all of the days leading up to the 27th, so you have 5/21 to 5/27. And the days leading up to that, there are no marks on her face that are visible. Here you can see the 24th, for example. Again, clearly marked on that. You can see her face very well. No marks visible. You have one here from the 22nd, and it's the same way. There are no problems demonstrated here, nor are there on this other picture that is also from the 24th. So, if these things are real, they didn't come from the 21st. They came from another time. So who did they come from? Now, this timeline, it gets even more interesting because Ms. Esperanza, she says that she saw AH on June 4th, 2 weeks after Depp left the penthouse, and she says that AH had further injuries. So you have May 27th, then you have June the 4th, and on June the 4th, she has a bruise on her left cheek and two on either side of her neck in the shape of fingers and little less than quarters in size. Now, when Depp's legal team asked about this, saying, hey, where was Depp during all of this period? Esperanza replied, he was out of country. She is then asked who AH had been interacting with over this time, and Miss Esperanza replied, Elon Musk. When asked if there was anyone else around, she replied, no, no one else was around. So Johnny Depp's lawyer, Adam Waldman, he adds more to this narrative, saying, Johnny Depp left the country after AH's most notorious abuse hoax, where she claimed he threw a phone into her right eye. Yet 2 weeks later, the head concierge at the building testified, saw AH with a bruise under her other eye, finger-shaped bruises on her throat, and a bandaged arm. It was Elon Musk who had been coming up to Mr. Depp's penthouse during that two-week absence. Interesting statement, no. You can see that interaction here. Who had she been interacting with? Quote, Elon Musk. Anyone else, to your knowledge? No. When you say that there were hand marks, how big were the bruises? They were like fingers. On her neck? Yes. Which side of her neck? I can't recall. How big were they? Like a quarter. Little less than quarters. How many were there? Two. And then she had a mark, I think, on the other side of her neck. The other side of her neck, which do you mean? The left. So the opposite side of where the mark had been before. Mm-hmm. Was Mr. Depp still living at the building at this point? No. What other unusual interactions did you have with A.H., if any? I can't recall. Going back to the bruises that you described seeing on A.H., I think you said that it was approximately 2 weeks after she, the May 21st incident, when she made the allegations against Mr. Depp. Is that right? Yes. What did the bruises look like? Hand marks. And where were they? On her neck. Was Mr. Depp in the building at that point in time? No. To your knowledge, where was Mr. Depp? Out of the country. Was there anyone else that she had been interacting with during that period of time? Yes, and she brings up Elon Musk. Now this, it goes further too. As the building security officer, Mr. Romero sounds off in this as well, saying that Musk visited AH late at night, quote unquote, several times a week while Depp was away from home filming, and this prompted staff at the building to speculate that the two were having an affair. Now when asked about how long this would go on, Mr. Romero claimed that the tech billionaire Musk, he would usually arrive at around 11 p.m. and would not leave by the time his shift finished at 1 a.m. So he was still around by 1 a.m. When asked if Depp was at home during Musk's visit, Mr. Romero replied, no. So this is what happened in the courtroom with Trinity Esperanza. Nick Wallace is covering this. That's at N-I-C-K-W-A-L-L-I-S. When it says QC, that's Queen's Counsel, we're talking about the Sun's lawyer here. So the Queen's Counsel says, you looked at the CCTV, talking to Trinity Esperanza, and you gave it to Mr. Depp's lawyer, and there was something that caught your attention. It was some kind of fake punch gesture, which A.H. made with her friends. And that is miraculously or unfortunately disappeared. Queen's Counsel continues, I suggest to you that there was no fake punch. It was just A.H. laughing and joking with her friends. Trinity Esperanza says, no, I saw that there. That had been a point of contention too, with them even mocking the idea that they got away with all of this stuff. Queen's Counsel says, now, this footage is grainy. Trinity Esperanza says, yeah, you know, I disagree with that. Queen's Counsel says, and you looked at this footage yourself, and you looked at more footage than you were asked to, and you saw there was a date when Elon Musk entered the building, and then a later date in your statement when you say in your witness statement there were a number of marks on AH's body. Where? Trinity Esperanza replies, I forget exactly. Marks on her neck and a band-aid on her arm. So you see Elon Musk brought up in this, and you see those injuries brought up as well. Now, funny enough, Queen's Counsel is basically going to say, hey, how did you come about bringing up Elon Musk anyway? Were you led to that? So Queen's Counsel, how did you come to make a statement about Elon Musk when you were asked to make a statement about who you saw in May? You know, how exactly did he come up in this? Trinity Esperanza says, you know, I was being completely honest. Hey, I was just telling you what I saw there, basically. Queen's Counsel said, did you tell Johnny Depp's lawyers about Elon Musk, or did they first mention him to you? Now, the judge intervenes in this, so Queen's Counsel, they have to rephrase. Okay, I will put it to you that at no stage did she have marks when she was with Elon Musk. You know, basically, let's keep this on point here. We're trying to burn down Johnny Depp, and well, Elon Musk, he's not the one that we're trying to take out. Not yet, anyway. Not yet. Better watch yourself, Elon. So, Trinity Esperanza says, talks about seeing when she saw when A.H. told her she was going to get a restraining order. So, she's talking about there in May 27th, around in that time. Queen's Counsel, but did she have marks on her when she was with Elon Musk? Trinity Esperanza says, I don't know what they were, but I just saw marks. So, she had marks on her there. I don't know where they came from. I'm not sure what happened there, but I saw that stuff. Yeah, I'm telling the truth like she says before. Now, the cross-examination on that end, so you have Johnny Depp's lawyer come in asking, hey, do you like A.H. in this? And Trinity Esperanza says, yes, she's always been very sweet to me. No, have no problems there. So, you have absolutely no reason to dislike dislike her, do you? And Trinity Esperanza says, absolutely not. A.H., they continue, says, she saw you only rarely. Trinity Esperanza says, what's rarely? She lived in the apartment. I saw her often. So, you'll see in paragraph 11 of your WS, that would be witness statement, that although you weren't on duty on the 22nd, you saw a Mr. Howard. Tell me more about that. So, Trinity Esperanza says, he was very excited to be delivering wine to her. He was very excited, a little starstruck, he says. She was lovely. There's a typo here that's supposed to be DS, not QC. On the days leading up to the 27th, did you see marks on AH at all? Trinity Esperanza replies, no. Had you seen those red marks that you saw in the photo, would you have said in your witness statement that you saw absolutely no marks on her face? You say, I looked at her right in the face and I saw no visible injuries whatsoever to AH's face. Trinity Esperanza says, correct. So this photo on May 23rd, makeup or no makeup, if you saw her looking like that, would you say that she had visible injuries? So they show her the picture where she's supposed to have the injury to her face. Trinity Esperanza says, in that photo, yes. It continues, but you said you saw her on that day and she had no visible injuries. Trinity Esperanza says, that's correct. They continue, and the same on the 24th and the 25th. You say on both of those days, there's no visible injuries. Trinity Esperanza says, that's correct. And you said that on the 25th, that her skin, it looked flawless, which yes, she agrees with that too. If she looked like the photograph taken on the 25th, would you have said that that photograph there, again talking about the supposed injury, that her skin looked flawless in that? Trinity Esperanza says no, and that pretty much ends the questioning. So isn't that interesting? No marks on her whatsoever, but when she was with this other guy, yeah, there were. By the way, Johnny Depp, he was never around during that time. Huh. Interesting. Again, not saying anybody did anything. I just found that fascinating. And I'm wondering, what do you think about that? And should Elon Musk, should he be watching himself too? But anyway, let me know what you think. And to close, let me mention our comic book. You'll notice the hours ticking down on this. We could desperately need your help, like I say, getting the word out, because mainstream sources, they don't love us. We're wrong thinkers, but that's okay. Again, we don't need them. We need you. We put together a great product too. We have 40 pages of full color. All ages love crafting and material. And picking this up, you also, because of stretch goals, you get 3 cards. You get a postcard as well, and a sticker to boot. And if it hits yet another one, we'll have a poster with that too. Let me say thank you as well for being here. Thank you for showing up and participating. You make this stuff possible. These people, they forget that always. And many people, they don't tell you that. But thank you. Sincerely, I appreciate you. And we'll do this again soon. Thanks.